Gloria a Cristo, Gurango, Nandavat, Sripad, Jagadgopal Prabhu. Happy to meet you again. How is everything in your place? All devotees are okay.
Dandavat Maharaj, here everybody's fine. We are getting protected, isolated from the world for against COVID. So we are more recluded, but we everybody's fine here. Make
Lockdown
some
is removed
square.
now. Lockdown is removed.
Sorry, Maharaj?
No lockdown there. Lockdown.
Unfortunately, no. Unfortunately, in Brazil, we do not have lockdown now. Just some restrictions that they say use mask in the street, things like that.
Bengal today they lifted partial lockdown. Some buses
Yes.
started to move. Some travel is allowed here for common
Yes.
people.
It's getting better in India, I think.
Yeah.
Very nice.
So, how was the response from last that interview we had? You have received some good responses, seems to me.
Yes, it was very interesting because many devotees get in contact. Devotees from
Uh-uh.
Spanish-speaking world, I can say that way, and some of North America also. And they come talking, making some questions, proposing some subjects, and saying that they enjoyed a lot. One devotee
Oh,
said something really beautiful that I would like to quote him. He said, "The truth shines by itself."
wow. So
It's beautiful.
darkness of misconception is slowly removed
Yes, yes.
by this all arrangement that you are arranging for this meetings. Good, you are doing a good service
Yes.
for me.
No, you are doing a good service to Srila Gurudev and Srila Guru Maharaj. They surely will be very happy. Srila Acharya Maharaj. So, Maharaj, I was thinking, so we can talk a little bit about preaching, some about normal preaching, scientific preaching, all kinds of preachings. What do you think? I think that's a good subject.
Yes, good. Very good.
But, so I think that one way to start is, what's the meaning of preaching? What's an effective preaching?
Actually, there are two things it is being told, achar and prachar. Only when you are properly following, then you can also make others follow by giving that same message that you are, trying to receive and implement in your life. It is known as, kirtan. Preaching is nothing but kirtan, actually. Actually, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, actually, you can find this in Golden Vulcan of Divine Love. Srila Sridhar Maharaj explained. He has told that Sankirtan means removing misconception in good association. That is the definition of Sankirtan. So preaching is nothing but Sankirtan only. It is a part of Sankirtan.
May
So
I translate it to Spanish, Maharaj?
yes, please, please,
I
please.
think that's a
Sorry.
good idea.
Sorry.
Yo estaba preguntando a Maharaj, ¿qué que nosotros podemos hablar hoy sobre prédica? ¿Qué es prédica? ¿Los tipos de prédica que se puede hacer? Y Maharaj está, yo pregunté a Maharaj, ¿o qué es una buena prédica? Una prédica efectiva. Él está diciendo que una prédica efectiva es el camino de Sankirtana, es seguir la instrucción. Please,
So,
Maharaj.
actually, Srila Saraswati Thakur telling, real definition of Sankirtan means removing misconception in good association. So, preaching is also part of that. Who can do Kirtan? Only who is first doing Shravan and Acharan. Shravan means you are listening from a proper source, not that you are listening any mundane sound. Some that is on a tanmatra. That is not Shravan.
Maharaj está diciendo que Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati dijo que lo verdadero significado de Sankirta es sacar la concepción errónea de nosotros por la buena asociación a través de los procesos de oír, de escuchar, escuchando de una persona que no está hablando de mundanidad, pero sí de cosas trascendentales.
And you are connected to a proper source, you are listening that sound, and nothing is happening to you, then you are not properly listening. So if you are listening the sound, then some effect must come in you. That means you will change your habit. You will come to proper platform of changing your way of thinking and living everything. That is known as acharan.
Que lo significado no es solo escuchar los sonidos materiales, sino escuchar lo que está diciendo este sonido. Que si tú escuchas eso, tú vas a cambiar, va a cambiar tu comportamiento, tu humor, y así va a tener un progreso.
If we ourselves not doing that acharan, First Shravan, if you are not doing Shravan and we are not doing Acharan, there is no question of, you know, Kirtan, it is preaching. There is no question of that. It is not possible.
No es posible hacer prédica si nosotros no estamos escuchando primero y practicando que nosotros escuchamos. Eso no es posible.
And those who are spreading their own mundane ideas, mundane conceptions, they're only creating disturbance in the society. New ideas, misconceptions, they're spreading. Not listening from the proper source. They're only creating misconceptions in the society.
Las personas mundanas quedan siempre haciendo misconcepciones, quedan haciendo concepciones erróneas en la sociedad, trayendo nuevas ideas y intentando cambiar las cosas. Siempre trayendo estas concepciones erróneas.
Our acharyas, Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, they all explain those things. They are only creating utpat, means disturbance in the society, by spreading their misconception.
Y uno de los Goswamis dijo que ellos están haciendo simplemente traer problemas a la sociedad. Es eso que están haciendo.
So, utpat cannot be called preaching. Utpat is not preaching.
Ese utpat no puede se llamar pregación, prédica.
Preaching means giving the message that is coming from above with some realization to others. Not just, you know, giving empty message. You yourself not realize and you not understand what you are giving to others. They will also not get proper benefit.
Predicar no es simplemente hablar una mensaje que se queda nula, que no se tiene contenido ninguno. Pero sí dirigir la mensaje que se viene de arriba, explicando con contenido. Porque si yo no comprendo qué estoy diciendo, las personas tampoco se van a comprender.
I was remembering the preaching mood of Prahlad Maharaj. Even though he heard something in the womb from his guru Prahlad Maharaj, not receiving mala, but he heard properly from his guru.
Y yo estaba me recordando del humor de Srila Prahlada Maharaj, de prédica de Srila Prahlada Maharaj, mismo que yo no recibió mala.
So mala devotees cannot do much preaching. Only they are interested in receiving mala. That is not enough. For they can get the proper, neither they can get proper conception, nor they can give others proper conception.
Por tanto, las personas, los devotos de mala, que piensan que todo es solo mala, no pueden predicar y traer la concepción verdadera para los otros.
Neither those mala gurus, they are just distributing malas without helping the disciples, their followers with proper conceptions. They can be doing any benefit in the society, nor their disciples can do any benefit in the society.
Y tampoco los gurus de malas, que solo se interesan en dar malas a sus discípulos y no dar ninguna instrucción a ellos. Ellos tampoco pueden hacer.
Mahaprabhu's mission is not a mala mission.
Porque la misión de Mahaprabhu no es una misión de japamalas.
Mahaprabhu instructed Rupa Sanatan with proper conception, proper mood, and they have taken it to their heart and practiced it, and that's what they have established, and their disciples also followed the same.
Y la concepción de Mahaprabhu fue lo que se instruyó a Srila Sanatana Goswami Rupa Goswami, una concepción que ellos establecieron y pasaron a sus discípulos. No es mala sampradaya.
Very simple thing. Mahaprabhu also preached when he was baby. He came and he's practicing. He's crying, and then everybody trying their best, but he's not stopping crying. When Hari Bol, Hare Krishna saying, he's stopping. So everybody understood, if you say Hare Krishna, then he will stop. In this way, he made everybody chant Hare Krishna. This is the way of him preaching. He himself practicing. He has to cry. He has to put some effort. He's practicing like that, you know. Influencing others by doing some moods, you know, creating some disturbance in the society for the good of the society.
Y por eso podemos decir que Mahaprabhu preguió un gran ejemplo y muy bello a nosotros. Por ejemplo, cuando era un niño chiquito, él lloraba, y las personas intentaban de todo para hacer que no llorase más. Solo cuando hablaban Hare Krishna, Hari Bol, entonces Mahaprabhu paraba de llorar. Y así, a veces nosotros tenemos que crear algunos problemas no, pero situaciones en nuestra sociedad para que podamos llegar a predicar el santo nombre de Krishna.
Who can preach like Mahaprabhu? As a baby he started to preach everybody by this type of, you know, practice. He has to cry. That means others are disturbed. When he's crying, others are disturbed from their work. Then they are thinking how to stop this disturbance. Then they have to do something. And in that way, he's, you know, influencing them in towards going towards spiritual direction by chanting Hari Bol, Hare Krishna, like that.
Por eso, ¿quién se puede pregar así como Mahaprabhu lo hacía, no? Pero es muy interesante porque Mahaprabhu está enseñando por el ejemplo. Él está llorando, criando algún problema. Las personas piensan, ¿qué puedo hacer para que acabar con este problema? Para no tener más este problema. Entonces las personas cambian y comienzan a cantar Hare Krishna para que Mahaprabhu pare de llorar. Y así es que se hace por el ejemplo.
Jeev jago, Gorachando kuni, bole, Bhaktivinoda Thakur Singh. Gorachando Singh, wake up, sleeping souls. That means we are sleeping in the lap of Maya, that dream of Mahavishnu. Then without disturbing, how can you make somebody awake? So preaching means creating some disturbance to awake somebody from the ignorance that they are sleeping at present.
Por ejemplo, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur habla, Jeev jago, acorden, despierten almas que están durmientes. ¿Cómo nosotros podemos predicar si no creamos una situación que es lo mínimo desconfortable para la persona? Tú no puedes acordar a alguien simplemente por no hacer nada. Tú tienes que crear una situación, tienes que tener este movimiento.
So, so many ways this preaching can be done. Through beating the drum and kartal, the preaching can be done, sankirtan, and the preaching can be done by, you know, delivering some lectures in villages. Delivering some lectures to the intellectuals at their levels and at the intellectual level, delivering, you know, some kind of, you know, prasad distribution, book distribution, so many ways, the widespread, you know, preaching, you know, different, you know, styles that are being designed by our acharyas. Narottam Das Thakur used to do big, big festivals to, you know, preach. So all this way, deity worship, temple establishment, all these things can come under preaching in a system that is designed by the previous acharyas. And also, according to time, place, circumstances, a acharya may devise a new way of preaching the same message.
Por ejemplo, nuestros acharyas establecieron muchas maneras distintas de hacer prédica. Narottama Das Thakur hacía festivales de distribuciones gigantes, en cuanto otros acharyas establecieron la pregación en masas, establecimiento de templos, otros la prédica científica y muchas otras maneras. Y por eso lo acharya de tiempos y tiempos viene y cambia, muestra una nueva manera de hacer este tipo de prédica.
Yeah, preaching means, in simple words, trying to give a message of the transcendental world to the suffering souls in this material world.
Por eso predicar diciendo simplemente significa, lo significado es que traer la mensaje transcendental a las almas que están sufriendo en este mundo material.
By that message, they can be delivered if they can take it properly.
Y por este mensaje, ellos pueden seguir y hacer propiamente, apropiadamente las cosas de manera correcta.
Sorry for the long answer, but this is what I can say.
Me disculpo por la respuesta un poquito longa. No, very nice, Maharaj, very nice, very nice. You know, I had a second question that's about prasadam distribution preaching. It's very common in Brazil and many countries. We make big festivals, so the people see very nice smell food, prasadam. They say, oh, I'm attracted to that. Then they eat. And sometimes they come to the temple just because the prasadam. They doesn't know in the beginning. They don't want any conception, anything. And with the time, they develop. So I think that's a valid way of preaching. May I translate?
Yes.
Yo estaba diciendo a Maharaj que hay personas que se vienen primero al templo porque nosotros hacemos distribución de prasada en la calle, en lugares. Experimentan y dije, no, eso es muy bueno, me gusta eso. Por tanto, viene al templo primeramente no por concepción, no por Krishna, simplemente por cuenta de la prasada. Si eso también es una forma de prédica que se puede ser hecha.
Yeah, prasadam is not different from Krishna. Krishna, his belongings, his associates, everything, there is no difference. So prasadam and Krishna, there is no difference. We are actually honoring Krishna actually by taking his remnants. So we have to be very careful with the new people. We have to somehow and other try to help them understand. They have to honor the prasadam. That is the first important thing. They should not, maybe they don't know what is prasadam and all those things. They may disrespect it, disregard it. So we have to be very careful, you know, when we are dealing with new people in such a way we should do so that they will not commit any offense to the Mahaprasadam.
Sí, eso es una forma que se puede hacer. Pero la prasada no es diferente de Krishna y de sus asociados. Por eso tenemos que dar alguna instrucción a esas personas que están llegando ahora para no desrespechar la prasada y sí poder dar honor, honra a ella. Y por eso es importante que enseñamos eso a esas personas.
And of course, we will take advantage of what people are liking. Like, you know, in America, people used to like halwa, and Prabhupada used to distribute so much halwa to all people, and by taking halwa, they become all, you know, very nice devotees. Prasadam, halwa prasadam.
Y por ejemplo, se puede decir que nosotros podemos dar a las personas lo que le gustan. Por ejemplo, Srila Prabhupada en los Estados Unidos, las personas le gustaban mucho de halwa. Y por eso, si la Prabhupada hacía mucho, le distribuía mucho, y así muchas personas vinieron a la conciencia de Krishna y se tornaron devotos, grandes devotos.
All those tendencies, some and other different individuals' tendency, we can direct them towards service and satisfaction of Lord and his devotees, and that will be very good for those jiva souls.
Por eso podemos pegar esta tendencia y encaminarla para una tendencia de servicio. Eso será buenísimo para estas entidades vivas, para su desempeño como, ya como almas. Yes, very nice, very nice, very nice. Maharaj, you know, I have a friend. He's near to me, actually. Maybe you can see him in the background.
Oh. What is that, monkey?
Yes, it's a monkey. And I would like, Maharaj, if you can talk a little bit. We are brothers. Maybe I come from him. Can you say something about that? About our preaching? I think Siddhartha Maharaj also say that. It's kind of preaching about Darwin conception versus subjective evolution conception.
Can you translate in Spanish?
Ah, sí. Yo estaba diciendo a Maharaj que yo tengo un amigo que se queda acá perto de mí, que es mi amigo mono, que se queda acá, lo monito. Si yo podría decir que si yo soy hermano de ello, o si nosotros vinimos del mono, con las diferencias de la concepción Vaishnava y de la concepción de Darwin.
So, actually, many people, I know, recent time, by the influence of, you know, some leaders who have spread some misconception that scientific preaching and the presentations against Darwin, you know, his ideas is not part of Sri Chaitanya Saraswati Mata's, you know, things. But they are actually only misguided by some, you know, unqualified individuals, actually. Sri Chaitanya Saraswati Mata is founded by Srila Bhakti Rakshak Sridhar Dev Goswami Maharaj, and Srila Sridhar Maharaj has explained, you know, in detail, and what he feels about, you know, Darwin's, you know, theory and in all those things. We all know that, you know, and I have posted a quote also of Srila Sridhar Maharaj today. I want to share that here in Sri Chaitanya Saraswat in an institute.
Maharaj estaba diciendo que es muy importante este tipo de pregunta y cosas así de comprendernos, porque infelizmente algunas personas hacían una campaña de decir que la prédica científica no hace parte del Sri Chaitanya Saraswati Mata. Pero por coincidencia yo puse hoy mismo una foto de Srila Sridhara Maharaj, de donde Srila Sridhara Maharaj habla sobre este asunto en específico.
Here Srila Sridhara Maharaj says, this is some portion of that quote is taken from the book, The Search for Sri Krishna, and there is a section, Fossilism versus Subjective Evolution.
Sorry, Maharaj, can you repeat?
This quote is taken from the book, The Search for Sri Krishna, Fossilism versus Subjective Evolution section.
Esta citación se viene del libro La Busca por Sri Krishna y también de la evolución subjetiva de la conciencia de Srila Sridhara Maharaj.
Here Srila Sridhara Maharaj says, by challenging the foundation of Darwin's theory, says, Darwin theory says that from the gross, the subtle is coming. At present, people are fond of the Darwin theory that stone produces consciousness. Darwin's objective evolution has swallowed us. Although externally we reject it, we hate it, still the ghost of Darwin's theory has devoured everyone. Therefore, it is difficult to make them understand that consciousness is more valuable than stone. It's easy for consciousness to produce stone. It is difficult for stone to produce consciousness. Consciousness is more valuable. Stone is less valuable. So a more valuable thing can produce a less valuable thing. But it is difficult to explain how a less valuable thing can produce something more valuable.
Srila Guru Maharaj, hablando contra las bases de la teoría de Darwin, habla que de la cosa que la teoría de Darwin dice es que la cosa es sutil viene de la cosa grosera. Primero se viene la cosa grosera. Y hoy las personas creen a la teoría de Darwin que habla que la conciencia viene de la piedra. La concepción de evolución de Darwin, de la evolución objetiva, nos está dentro de nosotros, infelizmente. Mesmo que nosotros por fuera rejetamos, decimos que no nos gusta, este espíritu de Darwin y de la teoría de Darwin queda infelizmente dentro de nosotros. De esta forma, es difícil de comprender que conciencia es más valoroso, más importante que la piedra. Es fácil para la conciencia producir piedra, pero es difícil para piedra producir conciencia. Conciencia es la cosa más importante, en cuanto la piedra es menos importante. De esta forma, la cosa más importante, mejor, puede producir una cosa de bajo valor. Pero es difícil, no se puede explicar cómo una cosa de bajo valor puede producir una cosa de grande valor.
Some lazy people who have not spent time to study what our founder Acharya has given, and you know, they have not taken direction from the proper qualified Vaishnavas who have understood all those, you know, teachings of our previous Acharyas. They have not spent time, only they have sentimentally, emotionally spent their time in devotional life, and they are criticizing what is a valid thing that is being told by previous Acharyas.
Infelizmente hay personas que son preguiçosas, yo no sé cómo se habla eso en español, pero hay personas que no le gustan hacer nada, no le gustan estudiar, y estas personas continúan hablando hablando con su humor de puro sentimentalismo en la concepción Vaishnava, ignorando lo que nuestro fundador Acharya, Srila Sridhara Maharaj, la Bhakti Rashaka Sridhara Maharaj, dijo a nosotros y su concepción.
Darwin says, life came from matter. Huh? Some pond of, warm pond was there and all the chemicals were there. And the chemicals somehow formed the first life. This is what is the idea that Darwin's theory presents for origin of life.
Y la teoría de Darwin habla que en el primero había una cosa y después, por cuenta de la química, se surgieron nuevas cosas.
Those people who are saying this type of in a presentation against Darwin not necessary, we will embrace Darwin's theory. Actually, they were embracing Maya, actually.
Yes. Y las personas que están hablando que nosotros tenemos que embarcar con esta teoría de Darwin, entonces ellas están siguiendo y abrazando, quedando cierto de Maya.
Krishna not says that the matter is producing life. Krishna never said that in Gita.
Sri Krishna nunca dijo en la Gita que la materia sí produce vida. Nunca dijo eso.
Krishna says that it is the soul which transmigrates from one gross body to another gross body. Dehino yasmi yatha dehe komarom yovanam jara tatha dehantara prapti dhiratattaranam yate. The soul transmigrates from the child body to youth body to old body. In this way, transmigrates to new body. Those who are wise, they are not disturbed by this process. And this is what Krishna says. Krishna not say that, you know, that those all gross body, they are producing soul. That type of idea Krishna never says.
Y si Krishna nunca dijo que sí es la materia que está produciendo vida, pero sí dijo en la Bhagavad Gita que la alma entra en el cuerpo joven, después maduro, después viejo, después muere y se va al otro cuerpo. Eso es lo que Sri Krishna dijo.
Darwin's theory explains that, as Srila Guru Maharaj has very beautifully explained, that something gross, these atoms, molecules, chemicals, they can produce these all, you know, things, senses, and mind, intellect, ego, and soul, everything that is coming from some permutation, combination, accidents of dead matter, inert matter.
Y Srila Guru Maharaj muy bellamente explicó a nosotros, contradiciendo la teoría de Darwin, que no es así que son las cosas.
So their idea is that gross is somehow manipulating and producing all the subtle things.
Sí, está diciendo que la materia sí produce las cosas sutiles, eso que Darwin dijo.
That's why they are thinking consciousness is a product of permutation combination of some chemicals.
Por eso pienso que la conciencia es un producto de químicos adentro de nuestro cuerpo.
But you see, so many machines are produced by scientists, starting from a small nail that you hit on the wall, or very complex, you know, these robots, but none of those mechanical machines that ever conscious systems.
Los cientistas hacen tantos experimentos, tantas cosas robóticas, pero tú puedes ver que no hay conciencia, no se puede crear conciencia, mismo que se cree la materia, que se cree logro cero.
Then they have never produced something conscious systems by some kind of mechanical arrangements of parts, that machines, they never become conscious.
Por eso nunca hicieron nada que es mecánicamente que tenga conciencia, porque no se puede hacer eso. Lo grosero no se puede crear el sutil.
But what we've also seen, the chemical reactions they do, much more complex chemical reactions they have done, starting from simple chemical reactions to, you know, polymers, long chain polymers. But none of them, those chemical systems become ever, you know, conscious systems.
Y que si tiene tanto conocimiento de reacciones químicas, Maharaj habló de tipos de reacciones, pero nadie, ninguna de estas reacciones químicas te puede producir conciencia.
So still now the valid idea is omnicellular acellular. Every cell comes from a pre-existing cell.
Por eso se habla que esa idea que si todas las células que existen se vienen de una célula sola.
So life comes from life. That is the principle. Life does not come from some mechanical arrangements of its parts as a machine or some chemical reactions of, you know, different chemicals. It is not life. Cannot be.
Por eso Maharaj está diciendo que así como dijo de las células, la vida sí viene de la vida. No se puede venir de productos mecánicos, no se puede venir de reacciones químicas o cosas así. Solo de la vida.
So the scientists, they started from chemicals, end up with chemicals. They never produce even a small, tiny cell.
Y tú puedes empezar a hacer con química, pero tú vas a terminar haciendo química. Tú no puedes producir una célula.
So that is one of the important things that everybody must remember. And also, a fish never become a frog by some kind of, you know, accident. A fish never become a frog, or a frog by accident never become some kind of dog. It never become happen like that. Or a dog become, you know, some kind of, you know, elephant, or an elephant becomes by accident become human being, something like that. Or a monkey or ape become a human being. That type of thing never happened. That is not the thing that we have witnessed in entire, you know, civilization of human race that we have seen and the record. It never has happened, nor the fossil record ever established that.
Y por eso tenemos que siempre recordar eso que Maharaj dijo. Y está diciendo también otra cosa, que no hay registro fósil para nosotros que muestre que los perros se cambia en un elefante, que el elefante se cambia en un otro animal, que los animales se por acaso se cambian de forma. Eso no existe.
What the genetics now added to Darwin's theory, which become neo-Darwinism, in that genetics, they are saying, oh, we say very similarity between the apes and in the human genome. The DNA sequence are very similar. So human came from apes.
Of course, my friend's here to prove.
So you can translate it in Spanish?
Of course. Yeah. En Maharaj está diciendo que hay una corriente nueva que se llama el neo-darwinismo, que habla que por qué los monos tienen parte de genética muy próxima de los humanos, entonces los humanos vinieron de los monos.
And you must be knowing that those small differences, they always maintained between ape and human being. In the cell, there is a proofreading mechanism. Like you proofread an article, there is a proofreading mechanism inside the cell, which does not allow its DNA to change into some other organism's DNA. So it makes sure there is double stage checking process, and there is a possibility of one error in 10 to the power 9, you know, cases. So accurate it is.
Sí. Por eso Maharaj está diciendo, pero la célula de un mono no se puede cambiar y se tornar una célula humana, así como la humana no se puede. Hay siempre un sistema que no permite que eso se suceda.
And then that maintenance of, you know, those differences in DNA is absorbed throughout the species. The species, the dog zygote will never by accident become an elephant by development. It will not happen like that.
Por eso nosotros no podemos decir que se vamos a cambiar de plataforma simplemente por químicas o por cosas materiales. Maharaj, you know, it's funny because I remember I studied in the past a few years Latin, that's a language, old language from the Western countries. And there's a quote I think from Kikero, he says, mens agitat molem. He say the consciousness molds and creates matter. The subtle comes before. But we are so drive today in this Darwinistic conception. It's so sad that.
Of course, this is a very important point what you have told. You see, the thing is that Darwin's theory only talked about some kind of bodily, similarities. But it does not talk about the behavior of a monkey and the behavior of human being. It's a vast difference, no? How a monkey behaves and how a human behaves. And that behavior, you cannot produce by some kind of, DNA insertion. The personality trait is not controlled by mere DNA.
Yes. Y Maharaj está diciendo que es un punto muy importante que yo digo sobre la diferencia y que la teoría de Darwin habla solamente de lo cuerpo, la similaridad del cuerpo, pero no habla por qué un mono se comporta como un mono y el humano se comporta como humano. Que eso no se puede cambiar. Un mono no se comporta como humano y así se sucede.
You see, in identical twins, the DNAs are same. When the single zygote, that divides and those two cells separate and they become two twins, adults, they take birth like that. Their DNA is same. And yet, their behaviors are different, even in the same environment. So they're having a big problem. If DNA is same, environment is same, why their behaviors are different?
Por ejemplo, cuando tú tienes dos hijos que son gemios, los dos pueden se criar en la misma casa, con las mismas personas, la genética es la misma, todo es igual. Pero ¿por qué se tornan personas tan distintas, con personalidades distintas?
So it's not just the shape that you are looking at. It is about consciousness. Consciousness of an ape and consciousness in human is there is a vast difference. And how can you control that consciousness by any material means? It does not come by any material means. Then there is a very detailed discussion about this in our Vedic literature, Vedantic literature about karma, the past, sanskar and all those things. And the scientists have to study all those things. And not just looking into, some kind of childish way, the secret is there in DNA. One scientist, James Shapiro, he has told, now at present, the entire study of biology is focused on DNA. It is something like a man searching the key under a lamppost. You know that story, right? And the key is lost in the forest, and there is a dark forest. So the light is only under the lamppost. So you're only searching for the key under the lamppost. So at present, scientists, they are thinking all secrets are there in DNA because they can manipulate DNA. So other complex things, they cannot understand. So they are searching the key under the lamppost.
Por eso es importante que los científicos conozcan estas cosas, conozcan de la conciencia, que es de donde viene todo, que viene todo. Porque lo que se sucede es que se queda en la floresta, en lo medio de la naturaleza, en la noche, procurando algo que se perdió. Pero solo quedan con una lamparina pequeña, y olhando, mirando acerca de la lamparina pequeña, se está perdiendo a la cosa, la llave. Y eso que Maharaj dijo, por ejemplo, la lamparina es la manipulación de DNA y otras cosas. Y por eso quedan ignorando todas las otras cosas como la conciencia.
So all these things has to be properly presented, all these challenges have to be properly presented to the people so that this misconception of Darwin, there are so many challenges are there. And the people will understand and, they will not accept such, misconceived ideas. And only foolish people have some objection to that type of thing.
Por eso es tan importante presentar estas posiciones, estos pensamientos a las personas que siguen la teoría de Darwin, para que puedan conocer la verdad, para que puedan ver de otra forma. No, y las personas, infelizmente, que son muy como crianzas, que son muy sencillas de pensamiento, no comprenden eso.
Sri Chaitanya Saraswat Math is not for dull-headed sentimentalists. Sri Chaitanya Saraswat, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Saraswat is there in that. It is for highly developed theistic, individuals, theistic intelligence. Krishna Varnam, Trisakrishnam, Sangopangasta Parsadam, Yajnai Sankirtaner Prayeri, Ajantihi Sumedasa. Who can do Mahaprabhu's Kirtan properly? Who have highest theistic intelligence?
Mahaprabhu está diciendo que el propio nombre de Sri Chaitanya Saraswat Math está diciendo que es la concepción de Mahaprabhu que se queda allá. Y la concepción que Maharaj habló en este shloka es que solamente las personas que tienen la mayor inteligencia teística pueden comprender lo que Mahaprabhu está diciendo y hacer sentir.
Krishna bhajan is not for dull-headed people. Je Krishna bhajan se chatur means only those who have good intelligence, they can do proper Krishna bhajan.
Lo bhajana a Krishna no es una cosa para personas que no tengan inteligencia ninguna. Sí, pero las personas que tienen esta inteligencia teística.
Some dull-headed people, they have not understood what is the teaching of, you know, previous acharyas and taking up some higher position and misguiding others. That is not proper, actually. We should not misguide people, taking away from what previous acharyas have established. That is only creating displeasure, actually, to all the previous teachers, acharyas. We are displeasing them. That is not good, actually.
Algunas personas, porque se pegan posiciones, piensan que ahora pueden presentar ideas que se difieren de las ideas que los nuestros acharyas dijeron antes, las guías que ellos dieron a nosotros. Pero estas personas solamente están creando problemas, están trayendo concepciones equívocas, solo eso.
We cannot say that, but Srila Sridhar Maharaj talk in length, so much explanations about Darwin's, you know, misconception idea, that is all, you know, not necessary. It is necessary.
Tú no puedes decir lo que Srila Sridhar Maharaj está diciendo es una cosa que no tiene importancia. Sí tiene mucha importancia.
Actually, sometimes people they think that spiritual life is all about some slokas, some prasadam, eating in the temple, and some emotional, you know, exchanges. They don't want to think about the teachings of previous acharyas more deeply, like Srila Sridhar Maharaj always used to say, dive deep into reality.
Que no es solo tú quedar en templo tomando prasada y leyendo algunos locas, pero sí tú tienes que adentrar a fondo en la realidad, como Srila Sridhara Maharaj dijo.
But, you know, Srila Vyasadev, he was highly intellectual, you know, personality, and he has given us all the literature, and yet, his guru, Narada Rishi, chastised him and he teach him what is the proper way of devotional life.
Por eso lo guru nos da es nosotros tenemos que seguir lo que es la propia concepción de vida que nosotros tenemos que tener.
Neither just mere emotional life of, you know, so-called devotion is enough, nor mere intellectual endeavors is enough. Both, you know, mentalities must be centered around a Vaishnava to drive it towards dedication and glorification of the Absolute.
Por ejemplo, no se puede decir que simplemente yo teniendo mucha sentimentalidad y decir que eso es suficiente para el Vaishnavismo, porque no es. Pero también decir que eso, yo tengo mucha mentalidad y mucha capacidad y no tengo ninguna de la otra parte, tampoco eso es suficiente. Tenemos que pegar una visión que se armonice las dos partes y una cosa sola. Esto sí es una vida dedicada al Vaishnavismo.
I want to share one Bhagavatam sloka, Narada Rishi's instruction to Vedavyas. What he instructs, and that will clear many of the doubts, misconceptions that people have.
Y me gustaría de compartir ahora con ustedes un shloka que se encuentra en Srimad Bhagavatam, donde Narada está instruyendo Srila Veda Vyasa.
So I'd like to share that with you.
Of course.
And this is from Srimad Bhagavatam 1.5.22. This is the instruction of Narada Rishi to Veda Vyasa.
Eso es de Srimad Bhagavatam, de se encuentra acá los números de, los, de donde se encuentra en Bhagavatam, la instrucción de Narada Muni a Srila Veda Vyasa.
Actually, Veda Vyasa has given so much of, you know, all this literature without, you know, clearly describing what is the proper, what I can say, pure devotional practices.
Srila Veda Vyasa dio a todos nosotros tanta literatura, pero nunca se dijo específicamente cuál es la práctica adecuada de la devoción.
Thus, people may think dharma, artha, kama, moksha, the four pursartas, that is all, is what religion is all about.
Por eso algunas personas pueden pensar que los cuatro pursartas, que es kama, artha, dharma y moksha, es todo que se habla de religión. ¿Tú comprendes eso? Eso es todo.
But Veda Vyasa understood. What I have given, that is not enough. People will not be delivered. He was very sad. Then his guru, Narada Rishi, came and given, you know, many instructions, and this is one of the instructions.
Entonces se quedó muy triste porque percibió que las personas no comprenderían eso. Entonces Narada Muni llegó y dio estas instrucciones.
Idhami pumsa tapasa sutasya va svitasya suptasya cha buddhi dattayo avichinto artho kavivir nirupito yad uttama sloka gunanu varnanam. So translation, learned circles have positively concluded that the infallible purpose of the advancement of knowledge, namely austerities, study of the Vedas, sacrifice, chanting of hymns and charity, culminates in the transcendental descriptions of the Lord, who is defined in choice poetry.
Por tanto, los círculos de personas estudiosas concluyeron que lo propósito del avance del conocimiento, hablando claramente de austeridad, estudio de los Vedas, sacrificio, canto de himnos, caridad, culmina en la descripción transcendental del Señor, que es manifiesta a través de esta poesía.
So in this translation, advancement of knowledge is also mentioned.
So, por eso está diciendo en esta traducción que lo avance de conocimiento también está dicho.
What is the purpose of advancement of knowledge? It must culminate in transcendental description of the Lord, who is defined in the choice poetry by the great devotees.
Por eso, ¿cuál es el propósito del avance de conocimiento en la ciencia? Sí, la descripción de lo Señor que se ha hablado a través de la poesía.
So scientific advancement is also part of that advancement of knowledge, and it is not meant for sense gratification. You know, those people, those foolish so-called devotees who are saying scientific preaching is not necessary, and where they are saying it on Facebook, using, you know, the science invention of this computer, all those things. They are hypocrites. They are using science for sense gratification as a mental concoction, but they think that that cannot be used for preaching the glories of the Lord. That is their foolishness.
Es una tolice, porque las personas que se hacen críticas diciendo que la prédica científica no es importante, hacen esas críticas por Facebook, por Internet, que es un producto de la ciencia. Estas personas piensan que la ciencia es para su gratificación de los sentidos y no para el servicio del Señor. Por eso hablan que no se puede usar la ciencia para hacer prédica.
Science can be used for getting vaccine. Science can be used for, you know, getting, you know, some machines to, you know, remove the cover of the rice, all these things. But science cannot be used for glorifying Lord. That is their misconception.
Para estas personas, la ciencia puede ser usada para lo que le gustan hacer, pero no se puede ser usada para hacer prédica, para hablar de lo Señor Supremo.
They are nothing but offenders at the lotus feet of Lord. They are thinking everything, you know, the science can be used for sense gratification, but not for service of the Lord, glorification of the Lord.
Estas personas son, la verdad, equívocas, porque piensan que se pueden usar de la ciencia para su gratificación y no para el servicio del Señor.
So here in the purport, Srila Prabhupada says very beautiful thing, and I want to read it, and you can translate it. Human intellect is developed for advancement of learning in art, science, philosophy, physics, chemistry, psychology, economics, politics, etc. By culture of such knowledge, the human society can attain perfection of life. This perfection of life culminates in realization of the Supreme Being, Vishnu. The Shruti therefore directs that those who are actually advanced in learning should aspire for the service of Lord Vishnu. Unfortunately, persons who are unarmed by the external beauty of Vishnu Maya do not understand that culmination of perfection or self-realization depends on Vishnu. Vishnu Maya means sense enjoyment, which is transient and miserable. Those who are entrapped by Vishnu Maya utilize advancement of knowledge for sense enjoyment. See, Narad Muni has explained that all paraphernalia of the cosmic universe is but an emanation from the Lord out of his different energies, because the Lord has set in motion by his inconceivable energy the actions and reactions of the creation manifestation. They have come to be out of his energy, they rest on his energy, and after annihilation they merge into him. Nothing is therefore different from him, but at the same time the Lord is always different from them.
Can I translate?
Yes.
Lo intelecto humano es hecho para tenermos avance en lo conocimiento de la arte, de la ciencia, de la filosofía, de la física, de la química y de la psicología, economía, políticas y cosas así. Lo cultivo de este conocimiento en la sociedad humana puede llevar a la perfección de la vida. Y esta perfección de vida sí culmina en la realización del Supremo Señor, Vishnu. O Shruti, así, instruye que aquellos que están avanzados en este conocimiento deben aspirar por el servicio al Señor Vishnu. Desafortunadamente, personas que se quedan enamoradas y la belleza externa de Vishnu Maya no comprende esta culminación de perfección y de autorrealización que depende de Vishnu. Vishnu Maya significa disfrute de los sentidos, que puede ser transitorio y miserable. Aquellos que se quedan presos en Vishnu Maya utilizan el avance del conocimiento para su disfrute sensorial. Srila Narada Muni explicó que toda parafernalia del universo cósmico no es nada pero una emanación de las potencias y energías diferentes del Señor, porque el Señor las colocó en movimiento por su energía inconcebible. As ações e reações desta criação manifesta, e vieram desta energia e repousam em esta energia, e depois da aniquilação, volvem a esta energia dele. Nada assim pode ser dito como diferente a ele, pero ao mesmo tempo, todo é diferente dele.
When advancement of knowledge is applied in the service of the Lord, the whole process becomes absolute. The personality of Godhead in his transcendental name, fame, glory, etc. are all non-different from him. Therefore, all the sages and devotees of the Lord have recommended that the subject matter of art, science, philosophy, physics, chemistry, psychology, and all other branches of knowledge should be wholly and solely applied in the service of the Lord. Art, literature, poetry, painting, etc. may be used in glorifying the Lord. The fiction writers, poets, and celebrated literatures are generally engaged in writing of sensuous subjects, but if they turn towards the service of the Lord, they can describe the transcendental pastimes of the Lord. Valmiki was a great poet, and similarly, Vyasadeva is a great writer, and both of them have absolutely engaged themselves in delineating the transcendental activities of the Lord, and by doing so have become immortal. Similarly, science and philosophy also should be applied in the service of the Lord. There is no use presenting dry speculative theories for sense gratification. Philosophy and science should be engaged to establish the glory of the Lord. Advanced people are eager to understand the absolute truth through the medium of science, and therefore a great scientist should endeavor to prove the existence of the Lord on a scientific basis. Similarly, philosophical speculation should be utilized to establish the supreme truth as sentient and all-powerful. Similarly, all other branches of knowledge should always be engaged in the service of the Lord. In the Bhagavad Gita also, the same is affirmed. All knowledge not engaged in the service of the Lord is but nescience. Real utilization of advanced knowledge is to establish the glories of the Lord, and that is the real import. Scientific knowledge engaged in the service of the Lord, and all similar activities are factually Hari Kirtana or glorification of the Lord. So this last sentence is very, very important. He says, scientific knowledge engaged in the service of the Lord and all similar activities are all factually Hari Kirtan or glorification of the Lord. So the use of science to glorify Lord and his glories, his, you know, what he can say, that literatures that he has given, that in a Shastra, presentation of those things, the teachings of the Acharyas in the scientific language is all Hari Kirtan. Hari Kirtan is not just beating the kartal and murdungas. That misconception that few devotees are getting from some of the leaders who have misconception, but that should be completely challenged.
Por tanto, en este sloka grande, I will resume this sloka in few parts. Está diciendo que todo se debe ser utilizado al servicio de la Señora, la poesía, la arte, la filosofía, la ciencia, la física y todo eso. Por ejemplo, citó Valmiki y también Vyasadeva, que ambos grandes escritores se tornaron inmortales a partir de hacer servicio al Señor. Por tanto, Srila Prabhupada concluye acá diciendo, lo conocimiento científico engajado en los servicios al Señor es, y todas las actividades similares son de facto Harikirtan o glorificación al Señor. Y Maharaj estaba diciendo que infelizmente algunas personas movidas por algunos líderes que tienen concepciones equívocas están diciendo cosas diferentes, que ese tipo de servicio no se puede ser hecho. Pero acá las escrituras están diciendo y también nuestros gurús.
You translated that whole paragraph? It's very good paragraph.
The last one, yes, of course.
The whole paragraph you can do is very good.
Okay. Cuando conocimiento avanzado es aplicado al servicio del Señor, todo el proceso se cambia absoluto. La personalidad de Dios, su nombre, fama, gloria, etc. Son todos ellos, no son diferentes de la suprema personalidad de Dios. De esta forma, todos los eruditos y los devotos de los señores recomendaron que asuntos como la arte, la ciencia, la filosofía, la física, la química, la psicología y todas las otras partes del conocimiento deben ser completamente aplicadas al servicio de los señores. La arte, la literatura, la poesía, la pintura deben ser utilizados en la glorificación de los señores. Los escritores de libros ficticios, los poetas y literatos celebrados normalmente se quedan engajados en escribir cosas de asuntos sensuales, pero ellos deberían cambiar eso y servir al Señor a través de escribir sus pasatiempos trascendentales. Por ejemplo, Valmiki, que era un grande poeta, hacía mucha poesía, y también Vyasadeva, que era un gran escritor. Ambos se engajaron completamente en delinear los pasatiempos y actividades de los Señor. De esta forma, se cambiaron en personas inmortales. De mismo modo, la ciencia y la filosofía también deben ser aplicadas al servicio del Señor. No existe uso verdadero para utilizar la teoría especulativa simplemente para la gratificación de los sentidos. La filosofía y la ciencia deben ser engajadas para establecer la gloria de los Señor. Personas avanzadas siempre se quedan con voluntad de comprender la verdad absoluta a través de la ciencia. Y de esta forma, los grandes esfuerzos científicos para probar la existencia del Señor en una base científica. Similarmente, filosofía, especulación filosófica, debe ser utilizada para establecer la suprema personalidad de Dios como todopoderoso. De otra forma, asimismo, todos los otros campos del conocimiento deben ser siempre engajados al servicio del Señor. En Srimad Bhagavad Gita también está afirmado todo el conocimiento que no eres engajado al servicio del Señor no pasa de neciencia, que es falta de conocimiento. La real utilización de lo avanzo de los conocimientos es para establecer la gloria de los Señor. Y eso es que es importante. Lo conocimiento científico que se fuera engajado al servicio del Señor y todas las actividades similares son, na verdad, Harikirtana o glorificación de los Señor.
Those foolish people who are saying scientific preaching is not necessary, science should not be used for glorifying Lord, but they have to understand they are sending their children to the schools, colleges to learn science, to earn some money, to sense gratification. They are using scientific discoveries for their own, you know, sense pleasures, but they are saying that science cannot be used for glorifying Lord. What kind of foolishness is that? From where they are learning all these misconceptions? Who is teaching them all these misconceptions?
¿Quién está enseñando a estas personas tal más concepciones equívocos? Porque estas personas piensan que pueden utilizar la ciencia para su gratificación de los sentidos, pero la ciencia no se puede ser utilizada al servicio de los señores. ¿Quién enseña eso a estas personas? ¿De dónde es que sacan estas ideas?
Also, Lord Sri Krishna says something very important thing, and that I want to share in Bhagavad Gita, one sloka, that is from Bhagavad Gita 3.21, and this is very important that everybody must, you know, understand.
Por eso me gustaría compartir también un shloka que el Señor Krishna habla en Bhagavad Gita, capítulo 3, shloka 21, que es muy importante de ser recordar.
There Krishna says, yad yad acharati shrestas tad tad eva tarujana sayad pramano kurute lokas tad anuvartate. Whatever action a great man performs, common man follow. And whatever standards he sets by exemplary acts, all the world pursues.
Que no importa cualquier acción que una persona grande haga, las personas comunes van a seguir, van a intentar imitarla. Y así, cualquier que sea lo padrón que sea establecido por los actos ejemplares, todo el mundo busca seguir.
If a scientist says you have to take this vaccine, I have no problem in accepting that idea. But if scientist says, some scientist says, and we are presenting Darwin's theory is not correct, this is what scientist say. No, it cannot be done like that. What is this?
Porque si un científico está diciendo, no, mira, toma esta vacina que te puede salvar la vida. Sí, me gusta la vacina, los científicos son importantes. Pero si un cientista está diciendo, mira, la teoría de Darwin no es así, eso no es correcto. No, eso no se puede ser usado así.
Leaders are saying, scientists are leaders. And what they are saying, you are following. Okay, vaccine you have to take. But we are also presenting those scientists, good scientists, those who are having belief on God. And they have presented some arguments against the materialistic ideas. And that you have some problem with?
Que si tú escuchas un científico que dice sobre la vacina, tú vas a tomar la vacina. Pero cuando tú escuchas un científico que está proponiendo cosas al servicio del Señor, la concepción de los servicios del Señor y que creen en el Señor, tú tienes cosa contra eso.
Oh, Actually, Krishna's idea is that if you can convince the leaders to take up the proper path, then common man will simply follow.
Lo que el señor Krishna está diciendo es que si nosotros pegáramos las grandes personas, los líderes de la sociedad, y convencerlos a hacer una cosa, las otras personas van a intentar hacer lo mismo.
Srila Prabhupada, having this idea, he has taken it from Mahaprabhu, like Mahaprabhu convinced Sarvam Bhattacharya, Prakasananda Saraswati, their leaders, and by convincing them, many people followed Mahaprabhu's teaching.
Por ejemplo, está diciendo que Srila Prabhupada decía de Mahaprabhu y Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, que si convirtió los grandes líderes como Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, entonces las personas empezaron a seguir eso.
So, Prabhupada thought people are following. At that time, actually, they were all following Americans. So he went to America to preach to the, you know, leaders, top class men. And he convinced Americans, then everybody also in India and other places who are not taking Prabhupada's, you know, preaching more seriously, they all started to take, you know, that message very clear, very, you know, seriously.
Por eso Srila Prabhupada, Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada vino al occidente, a los Estados Unidos, porque decía que en aquella época las personas escuchaban solo que los americanos estaban diciendo. Por tanto, si vino a los Estados Unidos, después los hindúes y todas las otras personas empezaban a seguir más seriamente lo que se estaba diciendo.
But scientists, they were not taking his message very seriously. That's why he organized a specific scientific Sankirtan party.
Y los científicos en esta época de Prabhupada no estaban escuchando muy seriamente lo que estaba diciendo. Por eso organizó una parte de estudios científicos, de prédica científica.
So he thought scientists are the leaders of the society. They are the preachers. Whatever they are preaching, people are accepting. So you have to make a preaching to preach to the preachers.
Por tanto, es muy importante que se pregue a líderes, pregar para los pregadores de la sociedad.
So there are three main personalities in that, you know, preaching team of Prabhupada, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Damodar Maharaj, Sripad Bhakti Madhav Puri Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Madhav Puri Maharaj, and Sripad Sadaputta Prabhu. They are the three main scientist disciples of Prabhupada, and Srila Sarup Damodar Maharaj was made leader of that scientific Sankirtan.
Y que Srila Prabhupada tenía tres discípulos que eran los principales líderes de este movimiento de prédica científica. Srila Bhakti Swarupa Damodara Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Madhava Puri Maharaj, Maharaj de last
Sadaputta, name of the devil. Sadaputta Prabhu.
Sadaputta Prabhu. Estos tres eran los tres que coordinaban esta prédica científica por Srila Bhakti Swarupa Damodara Maharaj, que era el líder.
And he told them, you have to preach two mantras to them. That is, life come from life. He specifically told that to Swarupa Damodara Maharaj. And he told to Srila Bhakti Madhav Puri Maharaj, matter come from life. These two mantras you have to preach to the scientists.
Srila Prabhupada dijo que tenían que predicar dos mantras. Que vida viene de vida y que materia sí viene de vida.
So Prabhupada's idea is this. If life is coming from life and matter is also coming from life, he used to show his fingernail. How I am living, so my nail is growing, so matter is coming from life. So if both are coming from life, then what is the first life? Then they will come back to Krishna. Ishwara Parama Krishna Satchitananda Vigraha Anadir Adir Govinda Sarva Karana Karana, cause of all causes. They will come to Krishna like that.
Y Srila Prabhupada costumaba decir que así como las uñas, la parte de los dedos, que se quedan creciendo enquanto se queda vivo, la misma forma la materia se desenvolve de la vida. Y que si tú predica a los científicos eso, entonces ellos van a buscar la causa de la vida, entonces se van a cambiar para la Suprema Personalidad de Dios.
Later on, when Srila Prabhupada, you know, disappeared from this world, then Srila Bhakti Madhav Puri Maharaj and Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Damodar Maharaj and some other, their god brothers, they all came to Srila Sridhar Maharaj for guidance by following the instruction of Srila Prabhupada.
Entonces, cuando Srila Prabhupada abandonó este cuerpo, entonces sus discípulos se fueron a Srila Sridhar Maharaj buscar instrucción.
So, Srila Sridhar Maharaj, those discussions, he always encouraged the scientific preaching. And those all discussion with those, you know, scientist disciple of Srila Prabhupada that is published in the form of a book called Subjective Evolution of Consciousness.
Entonces, los discípulos de Prabhupada que se fueron a Guru Maharaj hablaron con él y esta conversa se fue escrita en un libro que se llama La Evolución Subjetiva de la Conciencia.
And Srila Sridhar Maharaj told to Srila Bhakti Madhav Puri Maharaj and Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Damodar Maharaj that they have to build a temple on the tomb of the Darwin. That is the service that is given to them by their Gurudev, Srila Isivakrana and Prabhupada.
Entonces se dijo a ellos que ellos deberían construir un templo arriba de lo túmulo de Darwin. Este es el servicio que tenían que hacer.
People, generally devotees, also they only wants to accept what is popular. Many people what they are following Darwin's theory, many people are following, so they wants to simply accept. But that is not spiritual life. We don't go by, you know, popularity and voting. Actually, that is not spiritual life.
Y muchas personas simplemente siguen aquello que se tiene popularidad, que solo buscan eso, las personas más sencillas de pensamiento. Pero nosotros no tenemos que hacer eso. Nuestra búsqueda no tiene que ser por la popularidad de algo.
The devotees not adopted a scientific, you know, way of practicing devotional life. Thus, they are mere sentimentalists and developed many misconceptions in due course of time.
Si no tenemos este equilibrio de sabermos que también la importancia y practicarmos la prédica científica, entonces solo quedamos como sentimentalistas.
Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Bahunam janmanamante gyanvan mam prapadyante Vasudeva sarvamiti samatma sudurlabha. Very rare, a person who comes to even the conception of Vasudeva, very rare, may not be all following. That does not mean that I should not follow the proper thing.
El Señor Krishna está diciendo lo Bhagavatam, que hay, es muy raro, muy difícil de una persona llegar a la concepción de Vasudeva.
Socrates, when he was preaching his philosophy, many people were not accepting that soul is eternal, but he does not care the popularity. He given, sacrificed his life for establishing something proper. He lived for the idol and died for the idol.
Por eso está diciendo de un ejemplo de donde nos importa si las personas si creen o no creen que la alma es inmortal, pero tú tienes que hacer tu servicio y quedar haciendo esta prédica. No importa si tiene popularidad o no.
So, Srila Sridhara Maharaj always used to say, dive deep into reality, don't stay at the surface, try to understand things properly. What our previous acharyas told, they are not just, you know, based on some sentiments. That's based on scientific realization of, you know, all those, you know, concepts that they have presented. They are not presenting some superficially. They have a practical, scientific means practically experience those things.
Por eso Srila Guru Maharaj siempre dijo que nosotros no tenemos que quedar en la superficie, superfluos. Sí tenemos que adentrar la realidad, comprender los ensinamientos científicos, comprender eso, buscar comprender todo.
In scientific practices, they want to put everything else in the laboratory to test. But in Krishna consciousness, we want to put ourselves in the laboratory to test how much we are progressing based on, you know, different circumstances. What is our, you know, level of realization to tackle all those, you know, change or different, you know, environments.
Por eso los científicos les gustan de poner todas las cosas en los laboratorios de experimento. Pero nosotros, Vaishnavas, ponemos a nos mismos en el laboratorio para que nosotros mismos testemos a nos mismos en nuestro avance espiritual y en nuestra concepción.
Are we ready to put ourselves in the laboratory to test? Our Krishna consciousness is tested when there is, you know, some difficulties. Everything is going on nicely, then it's, oh, Hari Bol, chant Hare Krishna, take prasadam. But in difficult circumstances, how one is fixed with the teachings of the gurus, that is the most important thing.
Y que cuando nosotros ponemos a nosotros mismos en el laboratorio para hacernos testes, puede ser que tenemos momentos muy buenos, que hablamos, no, está todo bueno, Hari Bol, Hare Krishna. Pero ¿cómo que nosotros quedamos siguiendo los ensinamientos del Guru cuando las cosas no están así buenas?
This is what, yeah, we have to understand.
Eso es que nosotros tenemos que comprender, que tenemos que seguir los ensinamientos del Guru, no importa. Yes, very nice, very nice. So, Maharaj, I think that we already longed a lot of time. Maybe we can make another interview week.
Yes,
so we
yes.
can keep the other questions. What do you think?
Yes, yes, good. Actually, this is something, you know, very clear. If they want to, they are sincere to accept the teachings of our acharyas, not some, you know, crazy persons who are taking up the leadership position and presenting their ideas. That is, if they want to follow, they want to become crazy, then I have no problem. But if you want to follow what our previous acharyas, Lord has told, all those things, up to them. They have to decide what they have to follow. Yatha mam prapadyante tam tathaiva vajamyam. The way you want to come to me, I will also come to you like that. Krishna says that.
Maharaj está diciendo que es muy importante tenernos en mente cómo que nosotros queremos llegar a Krishna. Porque si nosotros queremos seguir lo que nuestros gurus, los acharyas, dijeron a nosotros, lo que la escritura dice a nosotros, eso es bueno, nosotros vamos a tener. Pero si nosotros queremos seguir algunas personas que se quedan completamente locas, también no hay problema, porque Krishna se aproxima de nosotros de conforme nosotros nos aproximamos de él. Eso no es un problema de él, no es un problema de nadie. Nosotros que escolhemos cómo nos queremos hacer nuestro servicio.
If they think themselves devotees and they want to also accept some apes are their forefathers, some monkeys are their forefathers. It's up to them. But we don't accept that. We say that no, our forefathers, we all coming from, you know, Manu, and Manu is coming from Brahma, Brahma is coming from Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, and like that we trace back. Krishna is the cause of all the causes. In this way we are tracing. It is not coming by some kind of, you know, accident, chance, all those things, the universe and everything. That we don't accept. We challenge those type of misconceptions and we present the Shastric things in a language that people of highest intelligence or even in the material intelligence, they can understand.
Y asimismo, cuando una persona se le interesa creer que lo mono sí es su papá, su hermano, bueno, la persona que cree lo que le gusta, pero nosotros no. Nosotros, el Sri Chaitanya Sarasvatamata, nosotros estamos estableciendo la posición de donde viene la evolución espiritual, la evolución subjetiva. No se sucedió todo eso por un accidente. No se creemos en esta posibilidad.
So they have to decide. They want to accept some misconception as their guiding principle or the conception that are being presented by our acharyas.
Por eso es una cosa personal. Tenemos que escoger si nosotros queremos pegar las concepciones equívocas o si los enseñamientos de nuestros acharyas.
Hare Krishna, Jai Gurudev. Vancha kalpaturi vasakipa sandhu bhaya vachapatitanam pavani bhyo vishnu bhyo. Dandavat, Jadu Gopal Prabhu. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.